Language is a problem in Buddhism, not only in Buddhism, in all human cultures. Especially in Buddhism, when Buddha awakened to the reality or Dharma, he had hesitation to teach, because it said he thought that truth or reality he discovered were too deep and too subtle beyond human thinking. Therefore, there's no way to communicate with other people. Even he explained, no one could understand. So he said he thought it's easier for him to just be there by himself and quietly die. But somehow, you know, the god, Indian god Brahma, came down and asked him to teach. I think that was a very difficult time for Buddha. In order to teach, he has to translate what he experienced into language. And that it took at least several weeks for him how to teach, how to express what he discovered using language. So it was a big challenge. And this challenge for Shakyamuni still continue today. What is the Dharma as reality? And what is the expression of Dharma or explanation of Dharma using language? When we study even the Buddhist sutras, we are thinking using discriminating mind, and we think using a concept or concept and logics. That is how our brain works. Otherwise, we don't understand what is said. Often, this written teaching or written expression of the reality is called a finger in Zen tradition. Finger that point the moon. So the real thing is not finger, but the moon. But often we think about the finger. So it's really a challenge for all Buddhists. How can we see the moon instead of finger? Often, Zen masters, without explaining using words, concept, and logics, their famous teaching method is hitting, shouting, and speaking something nonsense. That is to help their student to become free from their conceptual thinking. That is one part of very important Zen teaching. But Dogen has, in a sense, very unique Zen master. For him, expressing the Dharma using language is very important. He said, when we experience something, unless it is expressed using language, you didn't really experience it. So language, expression using language is really important. That makes our understanding also clear. So Dogen and another very well-known Soto Zen monk, whose name was Ryokan, he was also famous as a poet and calligrapher. Ryokan said, a finger is also a moon, or a finger is a part of the moon. In Dogen's tradition, language is really important. So that's why, you know, his writing, like a Shobo Genzo, is really difficult. He can ignore even grammar, yeah, or customary expression, habitual way of thinking, or he changed even the saying or expression appeared in the sutras or the master's sayings. So he in order to use language as an expression of reality itself. His way of reading, thinking, and writing is very creative. That's why his writing was so difficult for us, because unless we understand what he experienced, what he tried to express, you know, he, just reading his words doesn't make sense at all. Practice the same thing or with him, I think. That means in his case or in our case, practice the Zen and experience what he experienced. It's really important to understand his language. And when we share the same experience, we see the language is actual expression of what we experience, same as Dogen.